Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today is a new day. I've probably filmed this intro like a million times every like other day, but I'm finally sitting down and going to talk to you guys. It's been literally so long. Sorry, I'm trying to catch my breath and I'm hungry. I miss you guys so much. I've been so busy. And there's just so much we need to catch up on, but I'm fucking back and I'm never leaving. It's been a video that I've always dreamt of filming and I'm finally doing it. I moved out and it's already been like my second week moved out. I finally officially hit. It took me, I mean, I'm still adjusting, but like to finally be able to sit down and talk to you guys, it took me a long time. So I'm really happy that I'm able to do it now. I am in a different setting. I am in my new apartment. I've been wanting to show you guys it for so long. Where did it even start? I don't even know what to say. Sometimes when I turn the camera on, like I'll blank and like I'll literally be thinking about this and talking to myself about this for, I have been for weeks and days, and then I finally sit down and I'm like, wait, what am I gonna say? Where I moved out, why I moved out, if anybody gives a shit. I moved out because I've always wanted to. I think I'm able to get more on a personal level now that I live alone with you guys, so I'm definitely excited to be able to connect more with you guys, talk more about my mental health. Am I twitched? I'm sorry if I'm crooked. I can't really tell with my... wanted to move to Chicago, the city area. Just solely because I always felt like myself here. I always felt alive here. I would literally always beg my mom to let me go on the train alone when I was like 15 or 14 because I just felt like this was my escape. I felt like this was my home. And like, I think you know the feeling once you are somewhere like that where you feel safe and you feel like this is where I'm meant to be. And I felt my whole life like Chicago was where I've been meant to be. Obviously the snow sucks, but I think this year I'm going to try and see the silver lining with the snow, because that is definitely a downside to living when it gets cold over here. But besides that, I love the city. It's the most beautiful city I've ever been to so far, I've ever seen. Personally, I think that a lot of people take it for granted because a lot of people see this as something that is bound to happen to them. Like once they turn 18, they're moving out, college, everything, but that's not the case for everybody. So definitely very grateful that I was able to do this at 20 years old. And it's a choice. Like there's some people that don't want to. I think everybody has a different path, but definitely this was mine for now. Really happy to be living here. It's beautiful. I live in a great area. Beautiful area. I live very close to my aunt who's always lived in the city, so I feel very safe. It's happy. I'm happy here. I got a new job opportunity down here as well, and I start next week. I'm gonna try my best to vlog, and I'm definitely gonna try my best to bring you guys in my job life just because that is a huge part of my life, and I feel like I should. I did get accepted for my apartment, I think early August, I remember. This apartment that I am in right now, I literally applied for it. Like, I think I woke up and I was just like, do it. Whatever happens, happens. I think I had already gotten rejected by two other ones. So I was like, just apply. Like, it's whatever. It's probably not gonna happen. How many cars? Airplanes. Well, very scared because I was like, this has always been a dream of mine. And like, this doesn't feel real. I feel like it's gonna be taken away from me. So obviously instantly I talked to my therapist about it because she had known that I've been trying to move out for a long time. And I just kind of explained to her this fear of having something that I've always wanted, yet feeling like I could, like it was in my hands and I was going to drop it any second because it was just too good to be true. And obviously she kind of helped me come down. I didn't want to not celebrate or appreciate this moment or live in the moment because of my fear of losing something I've always wanted. I struggle a lot with that, especially when I get things, I feel like I don't deserve them, even though I worked really hard for them and I bust my ass for them. I feel like I don't deserve them. And I think that has to do a lot with me not rewarding myself when these things do happen to me. Like if I lose weight or if I get a new job or if I do this or things that I've always wanted to do, I don't really reward myself for it. So I always feel like I don't deserve it. In this case, I just told myself, like, I did everything in my power to get here. And I was being rejected, and finally somebody accepted me. Definitely had to sit down for a little and just kind of like take a deep breath and be like, this was meant for me. God wouldn't put me in this position if it wasn't meant for me. I definitely want to do a apartment tour once everything's furnished. Right now I literally have like a bed and two tables, but I'm trying not to splurge because I already bought a lot of things for now. Trying to slow down. Yeah. I've been wanting to tell you guys for so long, like, literally I've been filming, guys, but all the videos are shitty as fuck and then I end up not uploading them, but I've been trying to film. I wanted to film the moving in process, but that was just way too chaotic. I had all my family down here and it was just crazy. Now you guys get to see me decorate and clean. I deep cleaned my apartment yesterday and I was sweating. I cleaned my bath, my kitchen, everything. I want to paint my kitchen. Like, there's a lot of things that I want to do that I'm going to bring you guys along with. Whoa. Bobby.
What?
It's like super big flowers.
Nice.
Yeah.
The first time.
Good. They smell really good.
You told me that you loved me. My heart skipped a beat. I fell from my feet. Towards the ground, but I never touched down. You had the Cherokee, drove down to Brigantine wearing your favorite saw pretzels and ice.
We're at
breakfast at brunch.
Here's a bad time. There's no silver lining. Don't know where to find it. So I'll see
you.
Another place, another time. But everything I say is fucking right. And I'm your Valentine.
Hey guys, I'm out of work, literally a clip later, but I'm headed to the museum right now and I'm so excited and I look kind of oily, but it's fine. Yeah, hopefully I'm on the right train because I always forget. But I want to go to the museum. I want to buy some makeup at Sephora today because I've been wanting makeup. I want to go to Lush because I want to take a bath today. I want to go to Sweetgreen because I want to have a nice dinner. I'm just treating myself today because I've had such a shitty past couple of days. So I want to have a good day today. Even though I worked, I'm still going to make the most out of it. I wanted to change my outfit and I brought extra clothes, but I'm kind of like not even in the mood to change. So we'll see what happens. But yeah, I'm chilling over here in the motherfucking train. I really don't think I'm in the right.
Oh,
Okay, guys, I am finally home and I'm so tired. Like, literally. I get so tired so easily. So, call me an old lady. But I'm gonna show you guys some of the things that I got at Sephora. I just went in there really quickly. I already had some stuff on hold. Got a really cute bath bomb. You guys saw. I just like, I wanted to get more of the ones that were better for your skin, but I couldn't help this cute ass pumpkin. She said it had vanilla, clove, and pumpkin. So cute. Gonna be using this tonight because I need to relax. I have been needing to revamp my makeup and I really just wanna like get rid of everything I own and just restart because I'm sick of my makeup that I own right now. So I just got a couple things. I obviously did not pick up my birthday gift from Sephora and the girl was like, girl, get your birthday gift. So I got my birthday gift. If you didn't get yours, go get yours. But Rose Ink Concealer, I got it in the color neutral, which is the one she uses, and it was sold out everywhere. But like thinking about it now, she's super pale. So I don't know if this is gonna work. I just thought I'm always neutral. I don't know, if you don't know what I'm talking about, Rosie Hunting. I love her, I idolize her every day of my life, but she came out with a makeup line and I thought I'd try some of her products. So I'm trying the concealer first. And yeah, I think I'm gonna do a video on my next video trying like all new makeup products video. And yeah, I'm just excited. I've been like obsessed with makeup and I just like wanna look snatched. The packaging is so cute. I love opening makeup. Is it just me? Like ASMR makeup, I'm here for it. Also, any makeup that's aesthetic just makes me wanna wear it more. I know I'm not the only person, but looks like that. And I love thick brushes like this. I usually use my concealer as my foundation, so I love that it's thick so I can put it all over my face. This Merit, am I really close to the camera? I'm like hovering over you guys. This Merit Day Glow, the highlighting balm, it looks like this. This line of makeup is incredibly beautiful. It's very minimalist makeup, like barely have shit on your face, but I'm all here for it and I'm in love with it. It's called Merit and they have two different shades, but they've been sold out of the other shade for like months. So I just got this shade. It's called Kava. I don't really know how to say that. It's like a sheer glow highlighter. But the thing about highlighters is I don't like when it looks too glittery. It's so pretty. I need to give her a moment right here. You can't even tell how pretty it is. Yeah, you can't tell, but in the video you guys will see just the highlighting balm. I got this Merit lip stain. It's a shade slick, that's what they call them, but it's a tinted lip oil. I'm so excited to try this. Like, I am excited. It is sexy, beautiful, stunning. Tell me not. Let's watch it on myself. Oh yeah, that is the fall shade right there. Next, your girl is barely hopping on the Fenty Beauty bronzer, and I know I'm fucking late on this, like a year late, but this is the Fresh Bronze Glow. It's called Cheeks Out Freestyle Cream Bronzer, and I've been looking for a cream bronzer everywhere. It's in the shade Macchiato. I don't know why I haven't tried any. I mean, I've tried her lip stuff, but I haven't tried her face stuff. And oh, there's my camera. I'm excited. Like, it's Rihanna. Like, it has to be good. Ooh. I'm hyped. I'm so hyped. Next, I got this Say. I don't know how you say this, but Mascara 101. I saw Maggie McDonald talk about this mascara, and I'm not really a mascara girl. I always hate the way I look with mascara, but I'm a new person now and I want to be a mascara girl. So looks like this. I just prefer length over volume. I like when my lashes are long, fluffy butterfly lashes. I don't really want something like super volume crazy. We're doing a video trying all these products out on my face, so stay tuned for that. But for now, let's take a bath and go to bed together because we're bad bitches and we deserve it.
troubled up there. Stars shining bright above you. Night breezes seem to whisper, I love you. Birds singing in the sycamore tree.